Alright, what's up guys? I'm coming straight to you from Cone's Hospital. My wife is about to have a baby and she's taking a nap, and I'm about to take this time to motivate you, to encourage you, and I'm about to go over a couple of the documents in a closing statement. You know, when you're purchasing a house, because I want you guys to get this information, be able to know it and apply it and feel comfortable when you're doing a real estate transaction. So this is, I have about four deals that's closing on Friday. Today's Wednesday. This deal right here in particular is a townhouse that I raised money for to cover the purchase price, as well as the rehab. So I want to go over the documents that I just got that I'm verifying, so that way you won't have to make some of the beginning mistakes that I made when you're kind of looking at the prep before closing. So number one is, when you're the buyer, right, and you're going to close on a property, and you want to make sure that you get all of the documents before closing. So and you want to be able to go through all of those documents. Now, it's not that you don't trust the person that you're dealing with, or you know, it's not that, you know, it's you just simply want to make sure that what you agreed on is reflected on the paperwork, period. That's it. You know, it's your money, you earned it, and you need to protect it and you need to take care of it. So this is an investment. So the first mechanism of protecting your investment is to check your paperwork, right? Because your paperwork makes the paperwork, you know, at the end of the day. So the first, you know, first what you're going to get is a HUD. And this is a federal form. It's pretty much a receipt from the government saying, hey, you're purchasing a house, and here's what the numbers look like. So of course, on a property location, you want to make sure that's the exact address, and make sure that's right, so that way you're, you know, claiming title to the right property. Next, you want to make sure that your name matches. So, you know, of course, every smart savvy investor is putting their property in a trust or an LLC. So you want to make sure that LLC reads exactly how it's supposed to be. If the name of your LLC is Belcher and Belcher Properties, you don't want it to read Belcher and Belcher. If it's 1915 South Elm Street, and the attorney has it ST versus STREET, you want to make sure it reads, you know, properly, so that way when it gets recorded on closing day, that is in your entity and not someone else's. And then of course you just want to make sure that all the numbers are right. So in this particular case, we purchased this property for $8,000, and $18,000, and our private money guy is bringing in 25 grand. Awesome. And so it looks like the seller has some things that she owes, perfect, which we knew about. And after all said and done, it looks like we're getting about $6,808 back, so that we can take care of some repairs. Okay, so of course you want to check your name, your address, the property address. You also want to look at the attorney fees and make sure they didn't sneak anything extra in there. But the next document that you're gonna get is gonna be the deed of trust, okay? And the deed of trust is super important, okay? So the deed of trust is where your name and where your lender's name, if you got a mortgage, and where your lender's name is gonna be, you know, together, okay? So the deed of trust is the document that gives your lender, you know, the right to ownership if you don't satisfy the agreements that you guys made. Okay, so there's a deed of trust, and then there's a general warranty deed. The owner of the property is on the general warranty deed. Okay, so Belcher and Belcher Property owns it, so they're going to be on the general warranty deed. Now, Mary, Mary Sally Jane Lending Group is going to be on the deed of trust with Belcher and Belcher Properties because they lended on it. So these are two separate forms, okay? These are two separate forms. These two separate forms are the reason why you can buy a property and leave the mortgage in place, because you'll only be changing one form and not two. That's called subject to. Not going to get into that right now. But yeah, so you got this deed of trust, and then you also have the general warranty deed. Both of those are super important. Like I said, you want to verify and make sure that your company name matches on both of those. And then next we got the note. Okay, you know, of course, if you're paying cash, it's not going to be a note. But on this one, like I said, I got private money. So private money, all it simply is mean I reached out to somebody and says, hey, you know, I got this good deal. I'm buying it at 50% on the dollar. You're not making as much money in your accounts over here. I'll pay you an interest to lend on my real asset, and I'll pay you over a period of time plus interest to give you the opportunity to make money on with your money, and to give me the opportunity to, you know, to buy and hold real estate. So on this particular note, it says great, they're giving me 25 grand. We'll verify the interest rate at 13%, and then we'll verify how many payments it is, 144 payments, equaling $344 for the next 12 years. Perfect. And then there's details in that we just want to go over and make sure, you know, that looks as it's supposed to reflect. Me as the buyer, I prefer to always use my attorney. I think that's the right of the buyer, in my opinion. Since I'm the buyer, I get to choose the attorney. That's personally how I feel. I'm giving up my money right now. So I personally want my attorney on my side. I'm closing deals in North Carolina, so we're an attorney state. You know, of course, some states are title states, but here I get to choose my attorney that I want to use, and that's kind of a big thing to me. So next is title insurance. Okay, you want to make sure that's on the HUD. Title insurance, what that is it just makes sure that, so when the attorney does the title search, he's pretty much checking to make sure that the seller has the right to ownership, making sure that that the title is clear of any liens, judgments, or loans. They're making sure the title is clear, that nothing is owed, and this person has the right to ownership. And nothing's going to clout your title. So what he gives you is title insurance. You know, so that way if he misses something, his company takes care of that. You know, not us, the buyer, later on when something pops up. So title insurance is super important, because the last thing you want is for you to have a good deal and then 5 years later something pops up, a judgment from the previous seller, a tax lien from the previous seller, and they're threatening to foreclose you because you paid cash for the property, and now you got to pay that. That would suck. If you have title insurance and the attorney missed that, they're gonna cover that fee for you, so you don't have to come out of pocket for that. And what's more important than the title insurance is the title insurance policy. So there is a title commitment letter that you get from the title company. And not a lot of people ask for this, but I do, because like I said, I'm always raising money for the deals that I do. So I like to provide my lenders with the title, commitment, so they can see exactly what's covered if my attorney does by chance miss something, even though he's very detailed. You know, my two attorneys that I use, they're awesome. I mean, I've closed more than 100 transactions with them, and they're awesome. They're awesome. But yeah, the title commitment is very, 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 very important. Next, since I'm, you know, getting a note, of course, the amortization schedule is super important, because when you're using private money, you want to make sure your lender has amortization schedule, and you have one as well. Simply, what that is a schedule that shows you your payments, so your principal and interest breakdown over the term of the loan. So that way, if you decide to pay off it early, you know how much there's direct communication. You know how much the payoff is. Your lender knows how much the payoff is. Kind of got cut off there because my mom was calling because she couldn't get in the house. She got the kids. But yeah, so the amortization schedule is pretty awesome. You can actually, you know, kind of make your own if you go to just bankrate.com. But that's kind of it, to be honest though, guys. That's kind of it. So you got your HUD, which is like your federal receipt with all the numbers on it, with your company name or the entity that you're putting it in, with all, literally all of your numbers on it is going to be on there. And then you have your deed of trust, which has you and your lender. You know, if you're getting a lender in it, your general warranty deeds that is the owner on the property. You want to make sure that you have your title commitment. You want to make sure title insurance is on the property. You want to make sure if you're getting a loan that you have your amortization schedule as well. And then I feel like I'm missing one. So I want to just make sure I'm giving you guys all of the value in the world. Here we go, deed of trust, and of course the note. Oh yeah, so you want to have your note document that shows, you know, this is the breakdown for what you're getting from your lender, the interest rate and term. So hope this helps you guys out. Remember, when you're buying, buy at a discount. Remember, whenever you can, use zero of your own money. Learn this real estate game so you can maximize your knowledge and your time in order to make money. Remember, you don't need all three to take action. Have a blessed day.